Welcome, welcome, welcome. Good afternoon, konnichiwa, and also selamat petang. Well, this is what you want to display it. This is on all watching this channel, $2 here live all the way from $2. Live all the way from Southeast Asia, GMT plus 8. $2 here. Just sitting around enjoying my drink. Yeah, I got some drinks, so I'm not gonna show. But it's so obvious, it's where I'm just gonna enjoy my drink over here. Leftover from last night, yes, surprisingly. Leftover from last night and playing some daily Arknights and maybe perhaps later, chapter 7. But before I was actually, while I was waiting for the camera to charge. I suspect that's Blemishine. Let's Sophia, they were hiding from Sophia. Anyway, as I said, I was actually watching before I actually play Arknights. I was charging my camera. I was watching this one video. Let me check if I can actually switch to that. I was watching this freaking video, the tragic transformation of Nicocado Avocado. I've seen a few days. Yeah, is that man over there? I've seen a few videos of that guy, but somehow, I'm not sure. I was like, I'm not really a fan of him eating that much food. Seriously, it's like 10k per day. I was like, okay, not really a fan. And there's so much drama with that thing. I was like, okay. But my brother, he did tell me that he actually followed the guy in the beginning, and he actually started off as a vegan, and now he's like 300 plus, from 160 pounds to 300 pounds. Ooh, I was like, okay, in a short amount of time you gained that amount of weight. I hope your back and your knees managed to hold on to you, because difference between me, I'm slowly gaining weight throughout the years, but I managed to control it. And in, thank goodness, in 2006, 2007, I managed to reduce from triple XL to XL. There's something happened in 2008. So I'm slowly. This year alone, I'm proud to say I already lost 6 kilograms, which is good. But this guy is like, he wanted to. At first, it's like a lot of drama. It's like he doesn't want to lose. Maybe he's because he's streaming, whatever his reasoning. But eventually, he's proud and he wants to gain until 300 pounds. I was like, oh, it's like from 10 to 300, 160 pounds to 300 pounds. Difference between you and me, I said, I've been fat for a long time. I'm also active at the same time, so I developed some muscles to carry my weight. I hope you can, they can carry your weight. And I'm actually every single year wanted to lose weight, and I try to. And I'm this year, thank goodness, a bit of a lifestyle change and slow and steady, and managed to reduce 6 kilograms in 1 year. Okay, there is, for you guys it's a bit too small, but for me that's huge. This guy, okay, I admit I am drinking this right now, but it's not like I always drink this every day. In old days, I would gladly chuck 1.5 liter of Poker Ice Lemonade, but man, that guy, he really, really eats. Heck, even when I try to eat Indomie, the instant noodle, I can only go maximum 2 packets, and that's it. Heck, I even swore off eating a lot of buffet. That's a huge difference, man. And the amount of food that he consumes, especially junk food, scares me. I much prefer fine quality steak than the amount. I do know I enjoy McDonald's and such, but you push between that and a good quality steak, I would definitely go for a good quality steak. Seriously, I was like, what the F? I do know, I did say that I got a lot of instant food over there. As you can see, I got a lot of instant food over there. I got even Pepsi there. I got some soft drinks and everything over there. But even watching this channel, those things haven't really moved much for the past week. As that those are emergency food when I'm hungry. I have no intention of consuming everything within one go. Heck, even this one. I'm already content with. For a snack. And that guy, when he see the amount of food, that guy... Oh, God. I'm scared watching him eating that amount of food at his weight range. Man. Maybe I will change my mind. Have I known that he's actually start off big since he was teenager and still big until now? He maintained around that average weight around 300 pounds, perhaps. Or change a bit of my mind. But this guy, he ballooned up from 160 to 300 pounds. I'm not sure his current weight. But that scares me, man. But then again, yeah. One thing he gained from all that?
His money.
The video actually explained, is that this video, it actually explained, this whole video explained that he recently purchased around like $2.3 million worth of penthouse. It's been that the videos he's making, no matter what, creates so much drama, so many clickbaits and such, attention grabbing with all the larger consumer of 3 times the video, 10,000 calories worth of food grabs people's attention. It was like, oh, okay, that's his money then, that's his lifestyle. But how long will he live? I have no idea. But for me, that's a lot of red flags right now. Scares me. That guy really scares me. If he managed to, hopefully he can prove everyone wrong, and he managed to live at the prime age of 80 or 90 years old. Because, like smokers, not all smokers, yes, we do know a lot of smokers died early, but there are a few tough ones that managed to persist until they are 90. Yeah, they're still 90 years old and they still smoke. The quality of life is very debatable because I know these smokers, they tend to a lot. And yeah, if they don't have access to it. An amount of money, oh, thank goodness, when I was little. No, it was a teenager at that time. I actually came across like between A and B. I have that amount of money. And somehow it hit me really hard. Should I spend that money on cigarettes or food? Because at that time it was peer pressure. A lot of kids were doing this. Thank goodness, you know what? Screw that. I think, thank goodness for science. I learned about science. I learned about the effects of smoking itself. I didn't learn about economics at that time. But it kind of make logical sense that... if I were to spend money every week just to buy a pack of cigarettes versus a plate of food, yeah, food is way, way, way more better. At least food, if you manage to, if you can control CI, increase CO, then definitely, you would live a healthy life, happy life. A cigarette, once your point of no return, when cancer kicks in, sorry, goodbye. In economics, though. I still remember me making an economic joke regarding the smokers. They're good for the economy, and because I remember there was my senior at that time. We were joking around, and they were asking around from an economics standpoint of view. The smoker actually, what's the point of having a smoker, blah, 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 blah. This senior of mine, he's already dead, so rest in peace for him. But he jokingly answered, they're good for the economy. That, why, they say, one, you're providing jobs for the low-income earners, okay, that's one. But Two is that your government earned taxes from people smoking every year. Okay, cool. And by that time, those smokers need some medical attention when they're 70 years old. They cannot cash out that money to get treatment because they will die, they say. So the government keep the money. A bit down of a dark joke, but that's the reality of it. Hey there, Rombi! Hooray, hooray, hooray! Welcome, welcome, welcome to the channel to Modo Listen. Sorry, it was a bit of a sober opening for this thing. It's simply because I just saw a video earlier. This video, I'm talking about this video. The tragic transformation of Nicolcado Avocado. Yes, that guy. And he that video really, really scares me, seriously, because I'm not sure if you know about that guy, but that guy actually gained a lot of weight from 160 pounds to 300 pounds. And that scares me because you are a thin guy and within a few years you gain a lot of weight. Sorry. Cool. Just watch me. Even though I'm big and fat, and I do drink once in a while. But I am also aiming to lose weight, so no worries about that. I will still be here to entertain everyone. The world of Arknights and other gaming. Just don't expect me to play some Phasmophobia. Don't expect me to play Phasmophobia, okay? Expect me to play some waifus, some husbandos, and also some head. No. You heard nothing. I don't want this channel to be banned just because I watch head. Okay, so let's try it out. Let's see. Wait, is there a new banner? Okay, honestly, I'm not that excited about this banner. I already got Saga and Scuddy. Heck, I got even a better Scuddy. So, yeah. I don't want to add this. I already got Manticore. I already got Firewatch. Heck, oddly enough, for Firewatch, I got her off banner. She's not even rated up and she kept coming during those off banner. Hey, yeah, then we got Whispering, so I'm not gonna pull from this banner. Finally, an easy choice, not pulling from those banner. Welcome, Hellgate, welcome. Zed, it was a bit sober opening. I think Rambi was here watching the whole time. I was talking about a video that I watched about Nico Avocado. And man, that man scares me with the amount of... I know I'm fat, but... I don't balloon up within a few years from 160 to 300 pounds. I actually gain weight slowly throughout the years. So at least I got the back muscle and also the thigh muscle. I'm actually quite active during my adolescent year and my university years. I joined quite a number of clubs. Badminton club, football club, ping pong club, book club, board game club. I've been a photography club. Sadly, there's no manga club. There's no hentai club. And such. So yeah, I was quite active. Heck, I really like badminton. Simply because I'd like to do a reverse smash. Everyone like to do a reverse smash. My tricep is so strong, I managed to do a reverse smash. Hello there, I started playing Revive Witch. I have no idea what the heck is a Revive Witch. The only thing I know when something is revived is either they're a good thing or a bad thing. One good thing has been that you are the heroes of a group trying to save the world, or you are part of the Marvel Zombies universe and they are there to come and eat your brain. Speaking of Marvel Zombies, I'm excited to hear that they're gonna continue on making that series. You know, Marvel Zombies is one of my favorite series in the Marvel Universe. Oh, I read this comic and it was nasty. Imagine superheroes, but zombified. Oh, excellent. It is made by the company behind Arknights and Azure Lane. So revive Witcher. So what kind of is it the same like Honkai Impact? Or is it more like tower defense? Because if it's a tower defense, maybe I'll give a nudge and see how it looks like. Old school RPG like. Okay. Okay, I understand. If you understand what I'm talking about. Sorry, I'm that old school. Sorry, I remember playing my first game. What is it? Pong in the old days, like playing game like this. Yeah, I'm that old. I need to shave so I can look even younger. Alright. And slow. Now here's the thing. That slow is deceptive looking. Even though it looks like, oh, you will get a guaranteed 4 star. Because Orchid is 3 star. So you will not get that. More of an action citizen has no turns in battle. Ooh, nice. Alright. Alright, so we are clear with that. Cleared with that one. So while we're doing this. Okay, let me clear this one first. How many sugar do I have? Not enough. I need to farm more. Alright. So the name of the game again, what's that? Revive Witch, right? Let me double check. Let me check. Revive Witch. Okay, Witch? The frick has the... Oh, I think I forgot to set it up. Okay, yeah, I'm talking about this guy. This big guy. The Nikado Avocado. Man. Despite all that. All the controversy surrounding him. He is filthy rich now. He can afford to buy a penthouse $2.4 million worth. Good for him. Hope he lives long enough to enjoy his assets. That's all I can say. Revive with. Okay, so let's see some revive witch. Let me lower the volume a bit. Okay, we got there was a revive witch. Sorry, I can't see the chat. I can character named Ella. She's my main character. Don't know. Sure, also, didn't I show? Yes, I did. But after I watched it and I watched this guy, the Ricardo Avocado behind the scenes guy. Really, I was like, oh, seriously, that guy? I didn't know that he actually gained a lot of weight within a certain period of 160 to more than 20. He actually, here's the thing, he actually complained when he was 290 plus, 29 something, he was so close to turning it, then somehow he lost weight. He actually calculated how to get 300. Then also he calculated in order to lose weight, he needs 2 years to lose weight. And he just gave up? Just like that? I was like, the frick? Yeah, scares me, man. And then the video, when it released, that video, I was like, wow, really opened my eyes to his current condition. But what really opened my eyes is no matter how much drama he has, no matter how much, what's that called, the other one? No matter how much drama, no matter how much food, 10k per day he eats and everything. No, someone need to slap him and say, the reason you're going with this freaking 10,000, 10,000 calories food. No matter how much, he's still gaining a lot of views, traction, and ka-ching. So, yeah. So, doesn't matter. Yeah, his fame is mainly gained through eating a lot. In the beginning, he was a vegan. And he was thin. So people are allured to him eating. But a thin man managed to maintain thin weight. But then he noticed that when he gained weight, he changed his tactics. He eat food, junk food. And creating a lot of drama. I think I remember in the video he did mention that when he wants to, he wants to put your heart, he wants to say, it's like, is he want to cry or something, just that, first thing he immediately do is just grab a camera and just go in from the camera. It's like, wow. He can play the violin. I was like, man. I'm scared because I'm scared for him also, simply because there's a difference between a man who progresses through life slowly gaining weight at the same time gaining muscle to maintain his weight versus a thin guy who balloon up within a few years of that. I'm really, really afraid for his back and also his knees. That's all. Now he's a quirky fat guy that can play violin, same like me. I'm a quirky fat guy. I'm not quirky enough, apparently. Quirky fat guy that plays video games and wanna check out this game, Revive Witch. You know what? I'll just go to this one then. Worth playing. First impression. So this guy's 59k view. Let's watch this. What the heck is this about? Now, if you've been following my channel, I tend to watch YouTube videos at 144p and 1.5 or 1.75 speed. Sometimes it does work because the people, when they talk, that's like we talk very, very slow just to pronunciate every single word. Just realize that. But at 1.5, 1.75, really, really hasten things up. Here I am talking about Nikado Avocado with his eating habits, while at the same time I'm drinking Pepsi from KFC. No worries, already had a life adult. I know I enjoy food. As I said before, I do enjoy food. You push me between instant noodle and ramen, I would choose ramen. Between junk food and a good quality steak, I would definitely go to a good quality steak. But one thing for sure, I have already swore off eating a lot of buffet. Because I remember one point in time, that was in Ramadan, and half that month, 15 days over 30 days. Those 15 days I spent eating outside at buffet places with different people, different friends, with the family. So it's like this, today is with my friends, tomorrow is with my co-workers, the other day with school, the other way is with my family. So after that month, when the Ramadan is ended, Raya is come, and when I feel so, it's not because of pain of the, when I look through the weight, oh god, I gain a lot of weight. It's more like I feel so dissatisfied, I feel so bloated. I actually reevaluate life and also my pocket money. Then I said, no, screw that, I don't want to go buffet anymore. So nowadays when people try to bring me to buffet, I will ask them, they will say, please let me do a rain check. I need to double check. Have I been to recent buffet? And also, is it worth it? Okay, because if it's just a cheap buffet with cheap food, nothing that is, then I would give it once in a while. But if it's an expensive buffet, and that expensive buffet with good quality food, I would definitely go there. Yeah, I swore off buffet after a very, very long time. And which is good because now at that time, at point of time, I then temporized, because buffet food, they tend to have not serve us, especially there's one place in our country they serve us buffet food. I would definitely avoid the sushi one because their sushi suck. The rice is dry as heck. It's so dry, the Sahara Desert decided to give the title of the driest place on earth to them. Fun fact, Sahara Desert is not the driest place on earth. It's actually the Antarctica. So, yeah. But anyways, it's the rice is dry. The sushi is there. I don't want to go there. No, and if I go for their buffet, I will go for good quality food. Not some crap and such. Okay, FG 30,000 pop lane gacha committee seems a try gacha for people to enjoy. Okay, I'm not surprised. Make sure not to join the body positive movement, it's so toxic. Yeah, I don't know how to comment on the body positive. It's like a pub. It's okay to be big, it's okay to be fat. Okay, sure, it's okay to be big and fat, no worries. But you are obese. How the bloody hell you can say you're okay with that? I am big, I'm obese, I have struggle. I worried about being diabetic. I've been worried about having high blood pressure. Heck, I will tell you this. I will be transparent. If I try to eat a lot of meat nowadays, I can feel my blood pressure spiking on my neck. And it's okay. When I look at this body positivity, it's not showing normal people extra weight 20-30 pounds. It's obese people. Really fat people. And this is coming from a fat guy like me. I have the rights to call them fat because they are fat like me. I'm 240 pounds, 160 pounds right now. I'm 137 kilograms, last weighted. Which is somehow I'm proud because I start off this year with 144 kilogram. I already lost 6 kilograms. I lost 6 kilograms. Slow and steady. Slow and steady. So I was like, how? Why? Why do you want? This is the thing, Dune. I know beauty is within, I understand, but fat, I don't mind. Thick girls, I don't mind. Chubby little girls, I don't mind. But obese girls like Godzilla level, like me, like freaking me, I'm Godzilla. If I go out, people will be afraid. Heck, children are afraid of me. They thought that whenever I walk around, walk around the town and they saw me, they thought like they from afar the kids will hear this. Because they thought that the Godzilla is coming, and when they saw me, they pointed me. It's, oh my God, there's a Godzilla coming! It's like, man, how can you be that body positive for being obese? There's a lot of diseases and complication being obese. Fat is one thing, but obese, oh. Okay. If you wanna know, if you become thin, they harass you. I find that weird. I also read something about people, the deaf community, when they want to get operation or something, just so that they can hear again, they got chastised by their own freaking community. What? Is that person right to listen, to see things, to feel like normal again? It brings quality of life. Why? If someone tries to, I'm just going to cut them off, simple as that. They're not normal obese, they're morbidly obese. I agree, morbidly. How do you spell, the fuck do you spell obese? O-B-E. O-B-E-A. It's obese, okay? thank you, Sun Attack. Losing 6 kilograms. I know, it's a hard battle. I managed to do it during my time in UK. I realized that when you lose weight fast, you tend to regain it. So I decided for the past few years trying to change slowly during lifestyle changes. So even though I'm sipping this cola right now, I'm sipping it. Don't expect me to drink it again tomorrow or the day after. Before this, I drank a lot, but nowadays I don't. Heck, that instant noodle, don't expect me to eat it every single day. I change a bit, so instead of instant noodle, I would definitely get a real noodle and cook my own mee goreng and such, a real one. With less salt, with less sato. Losing weight is hard no matter what anyone says. True. Definitely true. Here's the thing. Smokers, if they want to quit, they have nicotine patch waiting for them. Because they're addicted to nicotine. So they can slowly wean off. They could vape e-cigarettes to slowly reduce their nicotine. So they have help. Fat people, we're addicted to sugar. We're addicted to food. And the first thing, I hate this. I'll personally tell you this. I really hate it when fitness instructor, health enthusiasts, the first thing they will tell me, hey, why don't you just quit drinking that cola of yours and just drink water? Seriously? Seriously? Thank goodness I actually finally have better advice. You know what's the better advice? Someone told me, hey, rather than you quit cold turkey with that cola of yours, why don't you slowly wean off from a sugar cola to a diet cola? Then once you're used to diet cola, once maybe 5 days diet cola, 1 day sugar cola, then move to cola zero, then slowly wean off diet cola, then slowly wean off, and that's what I'm doing, and it actually freaking works. Quitting cold turkey, my god. Don't go on extreme diet, since the second you don't diet, rebound hard. True, I have to agree. Fun fact, did you know most people get fat because of fat, not because of sugar? True. Vape can actually be worse. Now, yeah, true. Actually, the vape, yeah, it changed a lot. And honestly, it begins with e-cigarettes. E-cigarettes, I still remember that time everyone introduced was e-cigarettes. And it was purely used to help the smokers out there to reduce their nicotine patch. But knowing people, they bastardized the vape itself. And now, vape is the cool thing with the kids. Especially when I hate it when they suddenly, in the first take, I remember those liquid doesn't have nicotine, but now the company become wise. They add nicotine so that you get addicted to vape. You can already imagine how sad I was when I see that people were banning vapes. But actually, in the first place, the main intention of the e-cigarettes is to help the smokers. That's it. Oh yeah. Elgate says, oh, we got off track. We're supposed to watch Revive Witch. Yes, we do. Oopsie. Every single time. Okay. Sip is for you guys. I don't want you guys to spend watching it at 144p. I'm feeling a bit generous. I will spend a bit on 240p. Okay, 240p? Okay. That hurts my eyes. Okay, I'll go for 360p then. But yeah, I'm a bit sad that the vape, because it changed a lot because of the vape, it has been bastardized so much that it becomes so cool to smoke again. I'm so sad. It's supposed, as I said, it's supposed to be easier helping the non-smokers. Hopefully the non-smokers can find another way to really wean off. It's at the end of the month, it's okay to splurge. I see what you did there. Anyways. Sorry, if the sound attack is not. If my information on vape is wrong, you may correct me. I'm a man of science. If I'm wrong, prove me wrong, and I will change my mind. As long as the science is sound, that's it. Just like vaccinated or flat earthers. Anti-vax and so flat earthers, they want to convince me they're right, but somehow their science is so wrong. Revive Witch, apparently, yeah, because Hellgate is playing this game. I'm just curious what kind. It's an old school RPG, but it's more action-y, so I'm just curious how it looks like. Because I know he's trying so hard to push me for Honkai Impact, but somehow I resisted Honkai Impact. Oh shoot, Sayonara also trying to push me for this. hang on, there was supposed to be a mini browser and game. Oh, why am I upside down again? What the heck? Hang on. The droid cam. Transform. Okay, wrong one. Oh my god, I'm still upside down. Transform. Yes, I'm back. Okay, I'm not a fan, but Revive Witch is nice. Fun fact, this game released almost a month ago. They were to play like it's like the beginning of the game, begging. All right. No worries, I'll be doing my call up. One good thing, ever since I decided to life change also, I don't go to shops immediately buy all the gassy drinks, the colas, and that. First I would look around and see if there's any good alternative, because I have to admit, I am actually addicted, not the sugar, I'm actually addicted to the fizzy drink nowadays. So it's very, very hard. Slowly but surely. If it works so far, my strategy works. I slowly lose 6 kilograms. So that is a good sign within 1 year. A lot of people, here's the thing, I hate it when people tell me, oh no. You need to lose weight until you're about 80 kilograms. Dude, I'm 140 kilograms. At that time it's 144. You want me to lose 144? You want me to lose 60 kilograms in 1 year? Yes, it's realistic. Go diet, extreme diet. Go keto. Go to the gym every day. That person already cut off ties with. I already cut off because that person is too toxic for me. Seriously, 60 kilograms within 1 year. Just going to do keto, fasting, intermittent fasting. Go to the gym. What? You want to kill me? Seriously? So thank goodness I decided to play smart and slowly lose weight. That's it. That's the best strategy. At this 6 kilogram, if I can maintain that 6 kilogram per year, I could, inshallah, 10 years time, I could achieve that weight at 80 kilogram. Yes! It's not healthy. That's why I cut off ties with that guy. I don't want to see that guy anymore, honestly. Okay, let's see. So, Flashy! Final Fantasy! Okay, one thing for sure. What the bloody heck? So many numbers on my side, on the heroes. So many numbers on... it's so weird seeing that. So many... Usually I play Genshin Impact or you will see those numbers, but... doing a static, you're not even moving from there, and you both of you guys are doing damage left and right. What the heck? Oh, they're healing.
What's going on, YouTube? My name is FG3000. I'm back in the place to be, and welcome.
Oh wait, what is that speed? Oh, 1.5. Okay, I will reduce to 1.25. That's a bit too fast.
To Revived Witch. This is a brand new hero collector brought to you by YoStar, the same exact team that brought you Arknights as well. Well, as Azur Lane and my friend.
Who is this? Mikoto. Okay, we got also a Mikoto. She looks. Oh, wait, I forgot to press play on this one. Wow. I forgot to press play on that one. Oh, yo. Okay, so Mikoto looks lovely. No. I will do the soul searching after the stream.
This game could not have come.
Did we pass by Ella just now?
Not at a better time. Dude, it's November. Right. And this is the very first, the only game that I've been genuinely excited to play.
Wow.
So excited. I'm feeling it way deep down in my plum.
Okay.
Now let's be clear. I know. Honeymoon period. The game.
So many characters.
It just came out yesterday. Nice. But when I look back at every single game that I played.
Oh, is this? Is this it? No, yours is Ella. This is Alice. This is. She's like Wolverine. She's like Wolverine without the. She's the female Wolverine without the healing factor, but has. The essence that is out of this world. Ella is the best unit in the game. She's the dragon girl.
This year, this is the most honey
Miku.
Feeling I have felt all year.
Is this it? No, this is Ulalia. Very interesting.
Long, and thankfully, it's
very interesting.
Brought to you by a company like YoStar, who you.
something else.
Faye.
No, is gonna keep the game updated, and of course, is the king of live.
Why doesn't this girl remind me of Suzuran?
2D. I know you're not seeing live 2D right now. Live 2D.
Not bad. Not bad.
And the king of fan service.
What's this? In and Lu.
Service. Now, when it comes to the live 2D, you actually have to ascend to unlock it. So that's like the original model. The live 2D unlocks there, and then you get all Yo-Starry. Look at that. You see all that stuff going on? I can't wait to see. Now, hold on. Speaking of king of fan service, wait, check it out, I normally don't do this early in the video, but check this out. You ready? You ready? Watch it. Dude, Yo-Star already on day one? Check this out. You ready? You ready? Watch it.
You guys are talking about Ella. How come you guys not talking about Arcana? I wonder why.
Dude, Yo-Star already on day one? Dropping.
Oh, wow. Look at that. Look at how she moves.
Skin's like this. Dude, soon as I unlock Ella, I am absolutely buying this skin. Dragon, or not a dragon waifu, Dragonkin. Let me make sure I get my species correct. Dragonkin waifu? Dude, yes. And
Dragonkin waifu, I think I play Brave Frontier in the old days, and yes, the dragon become a waifu and everyone loves her. Hell yeah.
Indeed. And check this one out, check this one out. You looking at the pixels? I might zoom in on it. You looking at the pixels? Why them pixels? Doing that. I never seen pixels do that.
He should be playing for Arcana instead. Oh shoot. I ran out of butter. Okay, let me double check first. Okay, game, hang on. I need to double check if I managed to claim everything again. Yo-Star, please. Okay, please tell me Hellgate and Sayonara. In Revive Witch, do they have claim all button? That's all I ask. Do they have a claim all button? Holy moly, that's me that there's no chance in hell there's a claim all button for this daily then. Oh god, every single day. Is Arcana free? Yeah, that is a good question. Can I play as a free to play player knowing your star? No, I haven't. No, I'm just checking it out because Hellgate keep mentioning about the Wicked Witch or something, and so I'm just checking it out, checking this out first. Okay, I haven't actually start graded. Okay, what am I missing? What am I missing? Broly God, I just haven't seen her. You know, I'm gonna spend more genium on this one. Spend some more extras on it because I got extra like 270, so it's the best time to actually use it up because I am so low on LMD right now. Okay, let's
back in the old school RPG days, apparently. So I don't know. So there you go, Yo-Star in the place to be. So let's go ahead and jump into gameplay. The very best way to kind of show off what Revive Witch is all about is just to do a live gameplay session. This is kind of like an RPG first hero collector gotcha, but this all makes sense once we jump into combat. Stamina base gonna cost me 14 stamina to jump in. The game does have an auto repeat, no sweeping or anything like that, which is, you know, but at least there is some type of quality of life when it comes to auto repeating stages. I'm gonna go ahead and grab myself an assist doll. We'll go for the psycho waifu here. In this game, you have three dolls, aka.
We got a psycho waifu. In Arknights, we got a psycho. We got a crazy nun. drink finish. Now, one thing I learned: if I consume this, then I need to consume this. It's not mean I'm deleting it; just that for the teeth. I've been washing my teeth with acid, so it's better like. Truth, fun fact, I haven't actually seen the dentist for like 14 years. Yeah, simply because I was afraid. But something changed this year. Decided to see the dentist, and thank goodness the dentist say, even though I haven't seen the dentist for the past 14 years, I managed to maintain good health on my teeth. I was like, oh, that's good news then, good news. So just do some general cleanup and that's it. That's good. For me, that's the good news.
Heroes that are on the field and three backup dolls, and then like I said before, you have an assist doll that doesn't come out and fight, but they come out and just throw an ability real quick and then dip out. Now, first things first, as we're jumping in here and kind of exploring the game, the very first thing I like about the campaign,
oh, you can actually move around. Okay, this is a bit different from Brave Frontier then.
Stages here in Revive Witch is there's no such thing as three starring stages, right? You don't have to worry about, oh man, one of my units died. Oh, now I don't three star. There's no such thing as that.
Oh, thank goodness. In Arknights, we have to worry about having a three, you know, jump. Can actually three star this? Can I know? You know, like your star. So thank goodness there is that feature. I wonder how's the storyline so far. I hope it's not that too depressing for you guys. Okay, cleared, alright.
Literally, you just win. And I actually kind of like that because that's more RPG style. You know, when you played old school RPGs back in the day.
My
and you
God, there's like so many things happening at the same time.
Beat a boss and you only had one unit left with just one HP.
So I'm from the old school RPG. So ATB is a thing where we take turns fighting. So okay, that the person. So that's it. So you can imagine like, oh my god, that's so fast paced.
But if you play a gacha game, you just got a one star, you got screwed. Here in this game, you can actually have some of those combat moments where you just barely defeat a boss and you feel good about it because you're not punished because, ah, you didn't get a three star. So you can literally use your entire roster, your main team, as well as your backup team and not feel punished for doing so. You'll love to see. Now, this is, you know, kind of like an RPG-ish kind of experience, right? You see me kind of, you know, walking around the stage, looking for treasure chests, solving puzzles. And I gotta be real, when I first played the game,
you run out of stamina super fast in the game, so don't worry about being overly grindy. Well, I'm not surprised. This is a gacha game. The purpose of a gacha game is to make sure that you play for a very long time. Just like Arknights. I'm still playing. Surprisingly, for a gacha game, this is the only gacha game I'm still playing after 1 year. Did you guys realize that? I've been playing Arknights for a very long time. Compared with the other gacha games, I don't call those names the games itself. But yeah, somehow I managed to maintain a long-lasting relationship with this game, Arknights itself. So you get a lot of stamina pots at first. Yeah, I'm not surprised. Even in the beginning of the game, you level up really, really fast. And then you come up to a point like, oh, it's the energy, because every time you level up, your energy, your stamina is refilled. So I try to be calculative and try to maximize this as much as possible. Artifact farming and gear jig. End game, you just end up grinding for gear until you hit a good one. Another artifact farming. Oh God! I wonder if there's a Diluc version in this game. Or Himiko-sensei, was it?
I wasn't
Wait, the other game is already there. Right. Oh, so fun fact today, because remember, my country has been closed off because of the pandemic. We're still not yet open to the world. And also we got this curfew from 10 p.m. until 4 a.m. So no one is allowed to go out. If you got caught even outside your house, you'll be fined immediately $500. So after a long time in COVID in this country, after three months, I finally get to bring my mother out to do some general shopping. And also, that's why I didn't stream this morning, for general shopping and also dining at a food court. It was at 50% capacity, no teenagers, no kids allowed, and only double vac. Single vax, get out. You have to go. You need to get yourself double vaccinated in order to go around shopping. So it's been a long time I get to enjoy a lunch with my mother outside at a restaurant dining. Even though it's a food court, but man, it's such a very nice it's such a very pleasant experience after being cooped up inside the house for the past few months. Seriously, that's why you're wondering, how come I'm streaming a lot now? It's because I'm stuck at home just like everyone else. Every gacha experience ever, 10 a.m. for me. Okay, so that's my auto, sorry. That's my bot. Okay, we clear with that one.
Kind of feeling it, and that's mostly me. That's kind of like a subjective thing, and it's mostly down to the fact that I wasn't really in an RPG kind of mood. You know what I mean? Like, you know when you're in an RPG mood, you're like, dude, I gotta play a new RPG. I wasn't really feeling that. Like, has nothing to do with this game.
Also, one thing for sure, whenever you give me an RPG, whenever you get an option to avoid the enemy or battle with enemy, you can already guess what I'm going to do. I will never ever avoid enemy. I will try to fight with enemy simply because I want their EXP and loot. That's it. That's the only logical conclusion.
Strategy game mood right now, so I just bought Total War Warhammer for the weekend to play. But I digress. I just wasn't in an RPG mood, so I was like, oh man, I really don't want to play a game.
Out of curiosity, is he clicking something? Is it click, 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 or is just auto battle? Is there an auto battle option? If there is an auto battle option, I don't mind. That will be like Bravely Default. After we set up a few times, then you can set auto to that. I like the game, Bravely Default. I haven't actually played the second game, Bravely Second, but Bravely Default, I already played it. As far as you can see, you can't avoid enemies too much. There is auto battle. Excellent.
Walking around maps, exploring, solving puzzles, trying to find treasure chests. But it's not that bad. Once you turn on the minimap in the settings, this is what I highly recommend. Turn on the minimap in the settings to always display as you traverse the map. It'll make kind of going through the map and kind of finding, you know, the secrets and treasure chests a lot easier. So that is my recommendation.
Okay.
All right, so let's go ahead and grab this treasure chest here. I got one more chest to find, and I can also expand the map, see exactly where that chest is. Looks like I just missed it, huh? Teleporter. While you're in the stage, you're going to be, you know, little teleport locations, little zoom pads as well, because, you know, your witch does kind of have like a slow walking speed, but there are things that are on the map that allow you to kind of move around a bit faster.
Okay.
So here's a little encounter here. We'll actually talk about combat and get on topic. Now, the game has a universal resource meter that all your party share. So on the left side, you have this little skill bar that'll automatically accrue while combat is going on. And you can kind of see my abilities here on the left have a cost associated with them, right? So 2, 3 skill points, etc., etc. You build up 2 skill points, then you can use your abilities that cost 2. Very, very straightforward. Now, on the right side of the screen, which we'll see here in a second, you also have a chaos meter as well. Now, you got to forgive me because my team is legit. So I'm just like destroying these enemies really, really fast. But because I knew I was recording, I saved the boss encounter just for this video. So get ready.
Okay.
All right. Let's go ahead and grab this little treasure.
Prefer to spam. I auto battle this food if you know you can streamroll the enemy. Hell yeah.
That's right over here.
The game requires my attention again. Yeah. I haven't actually been to the barber yet. Soon I'm going to cut my hair. I said I'm waiting for a good time where there's not a lot of people shop. Then I'm going to cut my hair because it is kind of annoying when I have long hair. Fun fact, when I was in London, studying in London, and I had long hair, really long hair for the first time in my life at that time. It was so long, it's passed by my shoulder. And it was, I can't remember, springtime? Yes, I was walking around in Hyde Park. And someone actually tried to flirt with me from behind. That was like, when I turned around and faced him, the guy said, holy crap, you're a bloke. Sorry about that, mate. My God, do I look that sexy enough from behind with the long hair? I can't remember what exactly, but he was flirting with me from behind. It's like he's trying to catch my attention. It's like, I can't remember the exact word. When was funny though at that time? Okay.
here, and as you guys can see, I have discovered all four secrets here in this stage, and I'm gonna move on over to the next location.
Okay,
and,
show us
here
your mini map.
I'll let you know exactly where the stage exit is. You'll exit there. Load times are, you know, pretty non-existent, I would say, and the very best part about this game, for me at least, is the fact that it does not crash on emulator. Like, a lot of the games that I've just released are really crashy for some reason. I have no idea why. Like, they just hate emulators, but whatever. So, left side of your bar, skill points accrue automatically. As you use your skills from the left side of your bar, you start building this right bar, which is called your chaos meter. So your left hand skills are skill points, your right hand.
I don't really see. I wish he could use his mouse pointer and show us where is the chaos bar. I'm a bit confused. Where the heck is the chaos bar again?
Skills are chaos skills.
One more time.
Called your. Exactly. As you use your skills from the left side of your bar, you start building this right bar, which is called your chaos meter. So your left hand skills are skill points, your right hand skills are chaos skills.
Okay, it
doesn't. Once again, rip through combat there, get myself a little EXP action, and away I go. So okay. I need to find two more. Ooh! The combat coming up is quite difficult. Are you sure? Oh, I'm very sure. So a little bit of story. Like I said before, the game is very RPG focused. You're going to find lots of NPCs as you're going through the world with lots of little dialogue. Sometimes there's choices, sometimes there's not. But for the sake of the YouTube, I'm going to go ahead and skip the story for now. Something tells me FG been skipping the story even without the sake of the YouTube.
Okay. Okay,
I don't know why I thought that was so funny. You might be right. So, here we are, fighting a little boss encounter. And another thing I'm really enjoying about Revive Witch is the fact that I'm fighting monsters and creatures. Like, dude, that is like one of my favorite things about a gacha. I cannot stand a gacha.
Is it this one? I suspect that's the Chaos Bar. I suspect that's the one, okay?
Gacha, where you only fight other heroes from the gacha. Now, I know I played Exodus Heroes for a long time. Forgive that. I really prefer to just to fight really interesting and creative creatures. And this game has that in droves. I really love the pixel sprite design, especially because they decided to animate the sprites. If you think about a game like Romancing Saga, which also had some really great sprite work, but none of them were animated, right? The animations on these bosses and mid-bosses are really, really good. I love it, dude. And look at this, Dolphin Bay. There's so many good things about this game. I'm missing all the things that I love about it. Dolphin
Bay? Wait. I just realized there's a girl riding a dolphin. I just realized that. I was so focused on the boss fight. I didn't realize there's a girl riding a dolphin. The frick? The purple bar. Fun fact, the game explained it. Explained it all. Okay, good.
Dolphin Bay? Dude, I ain't never rolled a dolphin in a hero collector before. It's a first. All right, let's go ahead and knock this little mana thing. Mana is basically your gold and your EXP resource. It's like literally everything. Once again, for the sake of the YouTube, we'll skip the story. I still think it's funny. Let's see. Dude, I'm missing a second treasure chest here. Now, one thing you saw in that previous battle with the boss is this little bar right over here. This is like your I win button. It's literally an I win button. So as you're going through combat,
What button? My God.
Build up. Once it's maxed out, you can just freely spam your abilities for a limited time. It actually feels like an I win button. I kind of feel like, you know, we've gotten to a point in hero collectors and gachas that ultimates don't actually feel ultimate anymore. You know what I mean? Like, you'll be playing a game, you'll cast an ultimate.
Zombie would like to prove that wrong.
Man, you know, the entire screen blows up, you get this anime cutscene, the music starts playing, Sephiroth comes out and does an omni-slap. Well, Cloud does, my bad. I don't know what I'm talking about. All this stuff happens, and then the HP bar goes down like 7%, right? I still love ultimates, but they don't really feel ultimate anymore. They just kind of feel like another skill. In this game, that button literally feels like an I win button. Like, it just completely changes the game. It's not so strong that it's gonna allow you to beat content you have no business being in, but if you're in like a close encounter and you're almost about to die and you get that pulled off, you literally feel like you just completely changed the game, which you'll love to see.
Okay.
There you go. A little bit of combat there, a little bit of exploration, a little bit of boss action, a little bit of NPC dialogue, and then out you go. So that is the little final chapter there. You get your little chest reward exploration things, and you move on to the next node. Right now, I'm on chapter 2. Looks like there's chapter 1, 2, 3, and 4. They're actually pretty long, so don't let this fool you, and I bet you there's more content that I just don't have unlocked yet. These look like something. I don't know what they are, but they look like something. Outside of the main campaign world, you also have the Dreamland. Now, normally I don't spend a lot of time on your daily resource grinds because they're really kind of straightforward. Your mana Dreamland is really just a straight.
Okay, so if I were to start playing this game, definitely expect me to just like Arknights chapter 7. I just recently finished chapter 6 because I spent most of the time farming for resources. Oh, thank you, John, for following. John, I hope there's Garfield nearby. I'm kidding. This is Lee, but if there is a definitely I would like to have, I would love to, not, I don't want a pet Garfield, I would definitely want to pet that cat. I don't want to have that actual cat, because imagine trying to feed it lasagna every single day. You know that lasagna costs how much? And that cat can eat, my god. So thank you for the follow, John. And hope you enjoyed it. Currently, we're playing, since I'm doing the daily grind on the Arknights and stuff. At the same time, we're checking out the Revive Witch. Apparently, it is another game by YoStar itself. And so far, so good. This person, without the use of a mouse, I'm a bit confused how the game play. But so far, it looks awesome. Japan apples cost $6. I'm not surprised. Fruits are very expensive over there. Now I can understand when they have this culture where if you want to visit someone, you bring along a basket of fruits. I was like, what? In my country, a basket of fruits would cost you like $5 below. But apparently over there, those basket of fruits could cost up to $50. Oh my god. And I kind of find it a bit weird there, for that country really love their plastics. Like, imagine a single banana being plastic wrapped. A banana. And I was like, why? Why do you want to plastic wrap a single banana? It has its own wrapping, a natural wrapping. Trash Taste Podcast. I'm addicted to that podcast. Awesome. If you got something that you love, why not stick to it? I love it. I mean, I love listening, watching, reading manga. Yes, that's why I stick to it.
Ford resource grind. Like I said, mana is what you use to kind of upgrade almost everything in this game. It's okay. Gold, it's experience points, it's everything. This is like the bread and butter of the world. So you're gonna be constantly farming this stage. Nothing really.
30 cherries cost $30. 30. Yeah, I'm not surprised. This, everything is very expensive over there. In Japan. Very expensive. I still remember my friend, she went to Japan. Usually, I will tell you this, a typical cake and a tea in my country would cost you around, the most cheapest, $2. $2. The most expensive, around $5. But she says over there, a small portion of a cake and a small portion of a tea will costs $12 local currency. I was like, what the F? Yeah, it's that expensive. But no worries, Daiso is everywhere. Really expensive because it's brand that is grown in Japan. True. But my friend, I like Daiso, honestly. I wish that the Daiso, the Malaysian one, they have a Daiso there. But when I check on YouTube, the difference between their Daiso and that Japan's original Daiso is huge. I will tell you this. One of my checklists, if I ever go to Japan, other than onsens, pachinko tapala, because I really am curious how to play the pachinko itself. Definitely, I want to visit those 7-Elevens over there. The Daiso over there. The vending machine itself, that every 200 meters, my cousin can attest to it. It was like, yeah, it's like when I go to this vending machine, I walk a few minutes to the front, there's another vending machine. And when he walks again, there's another vending machine. I want to visit those places. Seriously. Cheap stuff is usually important. Ooh, definitely. I have to agree with you on there. Okay, we're gonna continue on. But somehow we haven't finished the
once
video.
You beat it, even with just one person alive, you then unlock auto, which you can then just auto repeat all day long. So that is that.
Now that is awesome. That is a very useful
thing. I do
feature.
Want to bring your attention to is the daily resource grinds for your characters. So you have ascension, you have equipment, and you have skill material. So let's.
Oh god. Yeah. So if I were to play this game, it's like Arknights again from the beginning.
Just jump over here.
I started Arknights a month after its release. This game is already 1 month old. Japan is one of the countries where it's not that fun to live, but visiting Japan is fun. I have to agree. I will tell you this. My country is the most peaceful in the region. Also, most of the boring places to live in, but it's a nice place to live in. We don't really have to worry about. If I want to do some more action, I just go to a nearby country and that's it. More than good enough. We consider expensive in the region. We are Singapore level.
To Ascension for a second.
But Singapore is more developed than Brunei.
Now, if you need Ascension materials for your guardians or your...
But then again, our country is like not even 500,000 people.
Healer characters, you can only use guardians or healers in that stage. I actually really love that, because what that does is it forces you to kind of dig deep in your roster and use and create teams that you might have never done before.
Oh, just like the CC event, sometimes like that strategy, that particular niche character is more useful, like Toma or Thorns last time, and also someone mentioned Weedy or Suter. Yeah, sometimes it does. But this one, CC daily event, you cannot use the guards, you can only use... Oh, it's your star again. That is the sign of a your star.
And then
you want stuff for DPS, you can only use DPS. Hell yeah, glass cannon build, baby.
Also, in a game like this,
that is one also
allows you to kind of enjoy all the other sprite work that you might have never seen. Like this character right here is the lowest rarity. He's like an R rarity. I would have never used his character under any other circumstance. But since I need a team filled with guardians and healers, I'm using this guy. And I'm like, dude, he looks pretty good.
That's like Myrtle and Vigna in Arknights. Why am I not surprised?
You're looking pretty good. Very, very nice.
Very
dude,
nice.
I'm loving the bosses here. Like, I haven't really been playing the game on manual, truth be told, but I'm just loving just the visual splendor of everything. Everything just looks so good. Now, I know maybe if you don't like pixel art, maybe it's not doing it for you, but there is just a lot of, you know, TLC in this game. It, just a ton of it.
What is TLC? I know DLC. What TLC? What the heck is... Oh, tender loving care. Okay. Sorry, just... Took me sweat some time to remember by 5 seconds.
Show you another one here. This is the Assassins and Destroyers. So this stage is limited to Destroyers, Assassin, and Witch class only. Now your Witch is your main character. I stopped using my Witch a long time.
Okay, that character reminds me of a Honkai Impact character. The one with the Sai. Can't remember the name, but Hellgate should remember her. Should remember because she got a massive Sai. Yeah, Honkai Impact. I remember Honkai Impact is also part of the Your Star universe. Wait, sorry, that's MiHoYo. Oh wait, oh god, did I? Oh my god, I bring shame to this channel. I shall stop streaming. No kidding, I'm kidding. Silly, never kidding. I know. I bring shame to myself. I just realized. I just confused your star with MiHoYo again. Oh god, please forgive me, gacha gods. Let me at least pull the 5-star and 6-star play. Hey, Bini Kano, Avocado, I can't actually cry like this. Why can't I? I'm kidding. That guy is too loud. Seriously, Chum, when I watch this video, when he suddenly cry as loud as it, like, what the heck? Is he over exaggerating or does he really cry like that? My god, my poor ears.
But you know, I digress.
And I think I remember he was like one of the videos I recently watched. He and his friend, the lady friend, they tried to weigh themselves. Never in my life I actually realized, because in the past it was like who would want a speaker for their scales, weighing scale. Now I understand who needed that. For which market needed that. I finally realized who really needed that. And when she needs a support just to hop onto the weighing scale, I was like, whoa. I remember she's like 500 pounds. I was like, nearly 400 pounds. I was like, oh my god, they really need help.
Yes. Here's this costume right over here you get for free, and look at her.
But if they're the bloody rich and they don't want help, okay, let them be then.
Throwing shortcakes at people. Dude, that's awesome. And like I said,
oh no, Heal! Right, my God, Heal! Don't let her die.
Heal is about to die, which in another hero collector would be really annoying. Like, ah, crap.
Oh, wait. What happened? Someone actually did replace it.
I gotta redo this stage. I didn't get my 3-star. Doesn't matter. You actually get to use your full roster in this game. If someone dies, you literally get to use your bench. You don't.
So you get a backup plan. Oh, that's beautiful. That's beautiful. Arknights didn't allow you a backup plan. No, they would have tried to restrict you. Welcome, Job. Welcome. Okay. Because Job is here, he gotta have his daily Arknights utage. So enjoy utage. You gotta enjoy that, man. Wait, something is happening. Oh, thank you, Satanic Cup. Thank you for the follow, Satanic Coupler. If I were to have you've got a couple with someone, make sure they're like utage. Make sure the RRR is very huge. I'm kidding. Don't just this. Okay, thank you for the follow. Thank you for the follow. Everyone loves utage in the swim. So who doesn't love utage? Unless you're a lolicon. Coupler is a train. Oh, I thought when you say coupler, sorry, I'm English is not a numero uno. It's not English. Coupler is a trait. I thought you meant coupler as in you try to match one person with another person. One is a Satan, the other one is a human. So they became a... I have no idea what they become. Succubus? I just noticed how her back support her badonkas. Me, I'm supporting her from the back. don't report me to Twitch, please. Don't report me. Hey, Zexinal, welcome. I'm Sadusim live all the way from Southeast Asia, GMT plus 8. I already gave you a clue, GMT plus 8. So try to guess from which country I am. I will give you a hint. Aku buku apak dalam bahasa aku ni. If you know that language, then you're my fellow countryman, definitely. Okay. Couple is a train. We both know you were dead serious, bro. Dead serious about utage. Of course, I am dead serious about utage, man. And I would love to pair up with her, and Pramanix, and definitely not Amiya. Definitely not Suzuran. No, they're not my taste. Lisa from Genshin Impact. Hell yeah. Hell yeah. They become one. Only the most degenerate. Oi, Hellgate. Oi. This is good content, okay? This is good content. Who doesn't love utage? Okay. Fun fact, it's part of my lexicon. Of course. I always use that. Who doesn't love utage? Tell me. Aku rasa aku dari negara lain, dari kamu. Ah, tatap tu ya. So kalau cara mu kelopak atau aku dapat pikirkan biskita ni dari Malaysia. So, kalau dari Indonesia, cara dorong kelopak lagi lain lagi. Bertukar konten. Yes! Even though you're satanic train coupler, but you approve the bertukar konten. I love it. Girl, man, with the girls out packing as much content as her. Yeah. I have to agree on that part, Job. But don't get honkers. Oh, Luruska! Okay, so. Tapi usulnya kita ni dari West Malaysia. Pasal kalau dari East Malaysia, Sabah, Sarawak, kumpul dorong paham cara aku bercakap ni. Kalau lurus, alhamdulillah. Kalau nak lurus, dah apa-apa. Enjoy utage. Okay, so enough with the utage story. You can get started anytime you want. Don't forget to visit that special subreddit on Arknights itself. There are more than utages, if you know what I mean. Oh, wait. Oh, shoot. Oh, no. I pressed the wrong button. Oh no, I pressed the wrong button. Where did we stop? Shoot, where did we stop? Oh no. Tia?
Like the best daily resource grinds I've ever done in a game. Like they actually feel
actually,
really good.
I'm actually watching this
And here's this
the game is called Revive Witch. Okay, it's with a W, not a, with a B. And so it's the same game by Yostar. So far, it's good. It looks good. Tempted to play. Tempted.
Costume right over here you get for free. And look at her. She's throwing short kicks at people. Dude, that's awesome.
All right.
And like I said, this character right here is about to die, which in another hero collection would be really annoying. Here. Like,
that's
crap.
Nice.
Now
that's
I gotta
nice. Just Google her and give me the magic code if you find them. Hell no, I'm not going to say that. My type is a strong one, like Hoshiguma. Oh, there's a special subreddit for that one also. Muscular girls. Like, even on Instagram, I actually follow more of a Oh, wait, why am I talking about that? Never mind. Let's move on ahead.
I got to redo this thing.
Seriously, that by Snunu.
I didn't get my 3-star. Doesn't matter.
You're a man of culture, Mr. Zack Zino. Definitely man of culture. Death by Snunu. And someday you'll match up with a girl. A strong, muscular one. And which will gluten your... Okay, never mind. Let's move on.
You actually get to use your full roster in this game. If someone dies, you literally get to use your bench. You don't feel punished for it.
That's,
very, very cool.
Good. Seriously, so many numbers. The last time I see this many numbers is when I'm in Genshin Impact. Honkai Impact. Yes, Honkai Impact. They have a lot of numbers over there. The ones with the Badoga Honka should have apps. Shoot. But I've seen some girls, especially on Instagram, they have really huge Badonkas. But they have a very slim motto. There's also a subreddit called Busty something. I'm not going to say the full name. My God, I'm a degenerate. Why am I a degenerate? Oh God, I should be purifying myself right now. Holy God, please. Yeah, there are some girls which I also question. How the heck did they manage and... they managed to maintain their weight. Even a big guys like me, I have to make sure that I stay strong enough to carry my weight. The thing is, I'm quite taller than Hoshi. Including the horns? Including the horns? My God, you're a very tall man. Should I use... Seriously, man. I can already imagine the amount of jokes when short people ask you to... because as a tall person, I can already imagine the amount of jokes. You should prepare a card, give it to them with all the pre-answers right now. I see a guy with a Badonkas obsession. Who the... Everyone has a Badonkas obsession, okay? Every single male. It doesn't matter if it's an A cup or a J cup or G cup. It doesn't matter. Every single one of us... is connoisseur in the female cups, okay? It doesn't matter A or the, some of you guys really like the A cups. It's your choice. Just make sure you're not a lolicon. That's all we ask. Make sure they're of legal age, okay? Loli Baba, perhaps. I don't have a Badonka obsession. I prefer good Thai. Ooh. There's another subreddit. Oh my God. So I know so many subreddits. I now scare myself. Oh God. I should stay off Reddit for a while. I really should stay off Reddit.
Dude, calm down.
Even the YouTube says to me, dude, calm down. Degenerate content confirmed. Oh my God! Okay, to the Twitch owners over there, please don't ban me. We're just doing this for fun, okay? Because I know you guys also love Badonkas. Doesn't matter. We don't judge you if you like A or double J. You guys love Badonkas also.
What is even happening right now? I don't even know what's happening right now.
See, even this guy on YouTube say, what is even happening now? Aren't we supposed to watching Revive Witch? Instead, we're talking about Badonkas right now. audio muted for the entire stream duration. Ouch. Yeah, I managed to, that happened to me once. We were playing some copyright song. When I want to watch the video, because I want to edit the video after the stream. Yeah, that from that part until the end, it's muted. All of them are muted. So that sucks. Sucks, Paul. So that's why I have to be very careful if there's any music in the video containing any copyright music. Surprisingly, they are very, very hard on that one. But Hot Tub Girls, they're generating a lot of attention. It was like, I'm actually debating if I should have a hot tub session also. Not for you guys, it's for me. What the heck, you guys are so dirty. You want to see me naked in a hot tub? I don't want to have a hot... I will tell you this. I don't have hot water in the house. So whenever I go to a hotel, I really enjoy the hot water. Hot water shower and hot water tub. I really, really appreciate it. So I'm a guy who always take cold showers every single day. Oh, I thought you just lost your voice halfway through the stream. Is that... Sorry, I was just messing with you guys. I just muted my mic. That's it.
I might have to read a couple of skills on these characters. Right. And like I said, that's kind of like the pro. Of
what? What's it? What the frick is happening over here? What the frick is happening over there? Three. Okay, the only person who wants to see you naked is someone who bought Ricardo's Avocados OnlyFans. Hey, here's the thing. If he can easily gain $1 million from that doing a session, then I have my own pride. Sorry, I have my own pride. I'm reserving myself for the lovely lady, okay? $1 million? Okay. Oh, hell yeah. Stream cold top session. I'm just gaming stuff. Thank you. I'm just gaming for the follow. Sadly, even though this is a gaming channel, we are somehow really, really talking about other stuff. It's supposed to be up to a point. I'm just debating if this is a gaming channel or a just chatting channel. Soon, this channel from a gaming channel to a just gaming channel to a cold tub streaming session. I love to butt with cold water toy. Yes, I do agree, but Zack Zainer, Taimane, at this time, because it's always raining, the water is very, very cold. And you know what happened when cold water hits your bum bum. So it's that cold. You have your pride. Don't fall down the rabbit hole. Yes, I have my pride. I will never, never, ever. I'm sorry. What? $1 million? Can you go? Hold on. I have to do streaming first. I have $1 million. Okay. Good. I have my pride. Okay. $15. $15. Hello, just gaming. Whatever floats your problem. Only the best discussion here. You can. Yes, the best. The best of the best. You can cold tub stream while Arknighting and chatting. Don't give me ideas, man. Don't give me. Oh, God. That is a bit too. Yeah, you know what? Here's the thing. Hellgate gave us a video. And we're supposed to watch it. This video is supposed to end 20 minutes ago. I'm still watching halfway.
Stages force you to use specific,
let's watch this video
character classes. Because you get to...
Oh, yeah. I'm actually debating if I should buy a webcam. There's a webcam. I know it's a cheap webcam for $35, but... $35 local currency, 1080p. The build is plastic and such, but that's the one that's currently within my budget. I can't remember the name of it. It's from Xiaomi itself. Simply because this mobile webcam, it runs on battery, so I cannot stream long. That's one of my disadvantage. So, and I need to, it takes some time to charge. So I'm actually debating if I should buy a cheap ass webcam for now and maybe upgrade in the future. Maybe upgrade in the future. It is not, I have to emphasize on this one, not for cold drop streaming, okay? That webcam is this for this channel. Okay, not for the cold apps. What do you mean, probably? No. Let's continue on.
Explore characters that you...
I have a currently 2K webcam I want to stream, but never had time to start. No, it is. No worries, man. Hopefully someday you get the urge. Because it's same as me. I'm inconsistent in streaming. It takes really some... Not motivation, really, really discipline, mental. Like to get the first push is also. I still remember my first video for my YouTube. It was very awkward. I was like, okay, so we're gonna talk about stuff and such. So that's me in the beginning, and now we're big degenerates over here talking about opis from A to double J's. Pretty sure you're the one who needs upgrading, not your setup. No, I hope you're, when you mean upgrading, the mental one, not this one. So, okay, I don't want to upgrade this. You don't want to see a double J on a man, alright? Sleep deprived cabbage. How the heck? What? Sleep? What the heck is a deep deprived cabbage? Hello there, Blue772. I'm sorry, Blue. I know you're expecting Arknights gaming right now, but we are so off topic. I have been off topic for a very, very long time. I can't remember the initial topic in the beginning. And we are supposed to finish watching this video like, I don't know, 20 minutes ago. My PC is on for the past 3 weeks, sleeping out. Okay, so we're back with Utage again. I think I already done with the daily. It's normal. What do you mean it's normal? It's not normal. You expect it's a gaming channel. You expect a gaming content, not some Utage staring at your soul and say, marry me and kiss me tonight, says Utage.
Might have never used before. Like, I don't even know what ability just happened. I literally just threw this team together just because. So I'm gonna have to see who does what happened there.
Oh,
that
wait.
Was crazy. So guardians and healers, destroyers and assassins, and then mage and compellers are the classes that you can use in these stages. And the same thing happens with equipment. If you need equipment for your guardian, you gotta use guardians. Need equipment for your assassins, you gotta.
Wow, this is so specific. Wow. So if you don't have enough, what happened if you don't have enough? Let's say enough guardians and stuff for that stage. You cannot do that stage. Or are you forever screwed? If you cannot do that state because you don't have enough units for that one. You rolled? Oh my god.
Assassins, once again, this kind of pushes you to level up more and more character classes. So very, very awesome. So that is your adventure, your campaign mode. That is your daily resource grinds, which actually feel...
Honestly, this one, okay. I have to be honest with you, Hellgate. This one is a bit pleasant to the eyes because I like to see like everything's neat and tidy on the left hand side, on the right vertical. It's like a graph, everything. When I look at Honkai Impact, it's like there's so many things to watch on the screen. I feel like my soul being sucked into this, like shattered. It was like, oh, what am I looking at? So kind of like this setup where everything's. Is neat and tidy, honestly. This is my opinion, okay? Roll. My opinion on Receive, which is quite enjoyable for now, is Yostar, makers of Arknights, the game that we are playing down here. I'm not going to be surprised in the future there will be Utage level character in this game, and you guys will be simping on it. Just like me. Wait, I'm supposed to mute that part. Oh, fuck. How did your CC 18 week 2 go? It was excellent. I managed to clear it. Thank goodness. After 3 hours of trial and error and some revelation, thank goodness. Because I want to use Suter, but it's very, very hard to kill those two big ass boys. then I realized that when I was looking through the unit's friends list, I stumbled upon a character that I quite forgotten, Bagpipe. Because Bagpipe, the beautiful thing about Bagpipe is that whoever got deployed first, they will got plus extra SP. So if you give it to Myrtle, she can actually create more DP. She can actually summon the DP faster. This means we can fast summon faster the others. So yeah, Bagpipe is the game changer for me at that time. Ooh, Bagpipe is a girl with a huge bagpipes. And a spear, yes. But I managed to do it. I managed to take goodness. And for the first time, Job, for the first time in my life, I managed to clear all the challenges in the CC permanent stages. For the first time, I was like, oh, thank goodness, I managed to win it all. So it's the first time. Also, sadly, I didn't manage to get one of the CC daily event. I didn't manage to get Risk 8. I screw up on that part. I thought, especially when Server Reset came, I thought that I can actually win it. Apparently, Crown Slayer is worth 3 points. So when she break your defenses, she's not worth 1. She's worth 3. So you screwed no matter what. Yes. Yes, I do. As I said, I am not a hardcore gamer. I'm a slacker. I'm here for Utage. Okay, let's continue on with this video itself.
Like, the best daily resource grinds I've ever done in a game. Like, they actually feel really good. Outside of gameplay, you also have this little area, which is called your Witch's Courtyard, which is kind of like a...
Why do I feel like this is like the base building of Arknights?
I don't want to call it like a city builder. It's not...
My key operators in CC number 5 is 18 is Prominix. Wow, nice.
Not like, you know, that time I was reincarnated as a slime. Not to that level, but it is to that degree a little bit. So you have your magic tree, which is going to be like your main base of operations. This is going to dictate how high of a level all these other buildings can go.
It's base building again.
Which allows you to take low tier gear to upgrade it to higher tier gear or higher tier materials. A little passive resource generation. Mirror of the other world is going to be your tried and true dispatch mode. I was going to say daily resource grind. Your
dispatch mode.
Characters out on a mission.
Now this is new. Arknet doesn't have a dispatch mode, even though we have a base building option. I thought like the other one, Fallout... something that like you base build and at the same time you can send out your units outside to do some resource hoarding or something, dispatching quests, but apparently they don't have it in Arknights. They have here, which is cool.
They come back in a few hours with goodies. Once they do come back, they get really, really tired though, and they can't go back on a mission until they rest in the cottage. Yeah. And my friend.
Yep, definitely. That girl really intrigues me. Now I want that girl in Arknights.
And I know this might sound hyperbolic. I've been hyperbolic this entire video, but this might be my favorite setting for a housing system ever, right? I've made housing systems in games that are farms, dorms, schools. What else have we done? Like all castles, but I love a cottage. Just a little cottage, dude. I'm feeling like I'm playing an old school RPG. Check it out. Look at this. Dude, I'm getting some Stardew.
So from the way he talks, see, this guy never played Arknights before. So I can already guess that. Definitely.
Dewey Valley vibes. Look at this.
Yep, definitely. This guy never played Arknights before. Yep.
Dude, I cannot wait to build my cottage here. All kinds of wallpapers, windows, couches.
And yes, I'm too also lazy to build up my base to make it look. I just want to get maximum. Have you seen my Genshin Impact Serenity Pot? Yeah, whatever I build, I just chuck it on the ground. That's it. I don't even bother making like other people. Whoa, they're trying to recreate Liu Wei's finest palace or something. I don't even bother that. I just make whatever it is. You want me to make a lot of those balloon thingies? I'm gonna make 10 of them. I'm gonna chuck it on the ground and get those points. That's it. More than enough. The Kratos way too fast. It hurts my head. Sorry about that. I'm playing at 1.25. Because I tend to watch a bit faster. This is lucky. Sometimes I will watch it at 1.75. If that person is so slow, I will watch it at 2. No worries. I watch anime at normal speed. I am not a monster. I gotta enjoy those. animation.
little decorations, and I'm sure they're going to be exclusive ones for events coming soon. Very, very nice. I cannot wait to make my little old school RPG cottage my own. And yeah. As you guys can see here, this is only the first floor. There's going to be more floors to come. Decorating, very, very easy.
Yeah. Just in case, if you guys are wondering, no worries, Satanic Coupler. Hope you can catch up with us next time. No worries about that. Sorry for making it to couple. I thought this is that the comment about coupling. I didn't realize it meant to a train. But I'm still... Maybe that train is a satanic nature to it. Anyways, hope you enjoyed the stream. I'll see you next time, man. Okay, I'm just going to set this up to normal speed, okay? So that Job doesn't get a headache.
Very, very easy. Now, obviously, it's in 2D and they're sprites, so you're not going to be doing any rotating or anything like that.
I can feel the slowness now.
Really easy to set up. Put things exactly where you want them. Wham, bam, thank you, ma'am. So, very, very nice.
Definitely the same as Arknight. They didn't even bother trying to rotate. It's just the same, just whatever. Hopefully, they can rotate this, the TVs and the sofas itself.
They are going to start feeling a little...
Have tried watching anime 0.75 speed, 0.5 on the head.
Better, as you guys can see, these are the characters that I just put out on dispatch missions. Once they get all their, you know,
I can already imagine playing, trying to watch One Piece at 0.5. Go, 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 go. I can already imagine that. Frame by frame. Hell yeah, Hellgate, you know what I mean. Speaking of Gomu Gomu no. Yeah. You can already guess which character is my... but sadly enough, I'm still stuck at episode 500 plus in One Piece. So yeah.
Their stamina back, I can throw them back out there to get myself some more dispatchy goodies. So that is that. Very, very nice. That's pretty much all I have unlocked at the moment.
Right.
I will be doing some follow-up videos. Really, FG, some follow-up videos. Really, you've been saying that the last three videos. I ain't seen a follow-up yet.
Wait, what? I just realized something. He can scroll all the way to the end. I can't do that in Arknights. Oh, that is awesome.
It's time for show. All right, this time for show. Friends list, I already posted my friend code on my community page. I showed you the Witch Courtyard. Archive just shows you what you've done. Commission board is like your achievements. Workshop, pretty straightforward. This is a place here where you can forge your gear. Now, this is going to be one of those games where you can kind of reroll stats as well. So,
is Genjin in back one more time? Oh god, farming for artifacts.
If I want to, you know, unlock, can you reroll? Actually, let me take that back. I'm not sure. I'm going to shut up on that one. I don't know if you can reroll these or if you can just add stats to it. And you just have to, like, get another piece of gear and hope that it has the right stats. I'm not sure. But
one thing for sure, if I were to play this game, expect me to join their subreddit and expect me to read up their guides a lot so that I don't want to waste a lot of materials and such. Then once I got the standard information in my mind, then I play. Then definitely, that's how I always play my game. That's why my friend would like to invite me, because I will try to read up and try to. In Genshin, you can't reroll stats. Yes, true, we cannot, which is sucks. Yes, it's very bad things in my opinion. Yeah, welcome to Genshin Impact. Welcome to Genshin Impact. Especially like, oh, finally, here's the thing. You will get a perfect at the substats. Oh, finally, attack percentage, attack, crit damage. Oh, I still remember that. You're hoping for crit rate to go up or crit damage or attack percentage. Instead, all of them attack. Who's in base attack only? Or worse, you got defense. Okay, you don't mind. Attack percentage, crit rate, crit damage, defense. You don't mind. Suddenly, all defense upgraded. Imagine all the guide says you need Ella, same as Arknight, Silver Daddy, Goat Girl, sorry, Ship Girl and such. Especially in the gacha game, definitely in the gacha game.
This is going to be where your kind of your grind comes in. Your long-term gameplay is getting a, you know, a good piece of gear, enhancing it with some enhanced stones, ascending it with...
So I assume the mana, the blue thing is your money. So you're going to be grinding a lot of money for this game. This is a gacha game. Whenever you play gacha game, always grind for money. Always. Arknights, I still remember I got $11 million. Now I'm back to $2 million because I'm grading my characters. Genshin Impact, whoa, so I got more than $10 million. Now I'm down to $3 million. Yeah, more up. Ouch. Well, I have to keep you chasing something in a gacha game. Well, that is their strategy, and it's working! Haha! Money is the XP, mat, gold, and stuff. Ow.
Like duplicates or other types of gear that meet the same exact rarity level, and then enchanting it to unlock things here, or maybe reroll, I don't know. I just started playing the game yesterday. Don't hold me to that right now.
Okay.
I already showed you dolls. We talked about adventure, and I showed you some of those nice costumes. When it comes to the cash shop, believe it or not, this is YoStar, which are usually, they're usually pretty good when it comes to not kind of overdoing it with things to buy. What I think I'm going to, ooh, look at this, free. Very nice. What I think I'm going to.
Oh, debate, YoStar, he's going to take the bait. He's going to, yep, he got it. Okay, so next time he will pay for it.
To do in this game when it comes to topping up, I'm not going to do it in this video. Like I said, I'm going to see how long the honeymoon period lasts. Probably gonna get the monthly card, because the monthly card, $3, that'll trigger your first top up reward, which will get you Luan here. I think that's her name. And it all.
You're not. Why didn't you guys talk about Luan? Yeah, she be packing. Hello, Pirate Mule. She's equivalent to a 5-star in. Thank you for the game, Pirate Mule. Very, really appreciate it. Is there a 6-star hero? Sorry. Wow, sorry. Rising is not the shield hero. Oh, okay, that took me 2 seconds to... Okay, I got it. I knew what you mean. Is there 6-star heroes? Because if it's a... That's a 5-star. I can't imagine the 6-star heroes. They are mine. Of course they're mine. The 6-star heroes. Oh, you mean ultra rare. Oh, this is the SSR. So you need to get a UR. Oh, God. So many. Why can't they... Okay, wow.
Also get you some sunglasses for your witch that I probably will never put on. That's
Okay, I get it. It's like, what is he talking about sunglasses on a witch? He's talking about that girl. Ella is a UR. I don't remember Ella being packing just now. The other girl was packing a lot.
Very, very nice. That'll get you that. But most importantly... If
yeah, it's that girl just now.
If you buy this...
Wait. I just saw...
That's very, very nice. That'll get you that. But most importantly...
Not this one.
If you...
Now, this is Ella. This is... This is a 6-star. Sorry to disappoint you. She's not as packing as the girl just now. I only start playing Arknights as a character is maxed out. You can just move to max out other character. Doesn't have to max out the gear or any other kind of bullshit extra set. Good. Try to level up. Don't be like me. Just to focus on the 6-stars and not bothering to level up the other characters. Well, when you have 100 other characters, yeah. So, like just like Arknights, I don't know how many operators I have. Let me double check. Let me show you guys how many characters I have. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 33, 34, 35, 36, 37, 38, 39, 40, 41, 42, 43, 44, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 50, 1, 2, 3, 4, 54, 55, 56, 57, 58, 59, 60, 61, 62, 63, 64, 65, 66, 67, 68, 69, 70, 71, 72, 73, 74, 75, oh la la, 75, 76, 77, 78, 81, 82, 83, 84, 85, 85, 160, 170, 171. Yeah, trying to level them up at this point will be resource intensive. There's a lot of resources. Characters along with you in your squad. Yeah, true. But trying to eat to every single one of them will not be enough within this 1 year. Right, you can check your ops at the profile, by the way. Is it? I can? Wait, how do I check my profile? Wait, what? Wait, that's not it. Is it here? Profile. How do I check? How many? Is this it? Operators are here. 169. Wait, 169? I thought I got more than 169. Because when I calculated 85 times 2, 16. Should be 170, 171. Who are the two characters not included? Interesting. Interesting. Very much interesting. Okay. Find my NBA pool, I got it. Word. I play for Avalon. I have no idea. I got Ella. You, congratulations, you got Ella. She reminds me of an anime character. Can't remember which one with horns like that. Anyways, let's move on.
Buy this growth fund, which is, I think this is going to be my main purchase. This is going to be my kind of...
So sus. Honestly, that is so sus.
My first purchase, and I'll see how the events go and the upgrade schedule or the update schedule goes. But if you buy this growth fund...
I think that's the reason why. Yeah, same with Zax. The reason why I stuck with Arknights is not only because of the tower defense game itself, not only because of the waifus. I don't really have to worry about rerolling Vogue. The only gacha is from the banner itself, not some Genshin Impact trying to reroll for the artifacts of this game, rerolling for the gears itself. Maybe. I could be proven wrong. Remember, I'm level 366. I can remember. 366 in Fallout 76. And I've been grinding a lot of materials over there.
You're going to get, you know, diamonds as you hit milestones. So once you hit level 15, okay, you'll have enough diamonds to turn around and then buy the battle pass, which costs 128. You see that? So I'm going to grab the growth fund, get to level 15, and then buy the battle pass, which will give me Ella here.
Oh, God. Your star is getting smarter.
And then I'll keep on leveling, get enough stones. That way I can then go over here and buy the costume that I'm looking for. Very, very. I hope she's good. I didn't even look at her stats or anything, but I hope she's good. So, yeah.
She's UR level. I think she will be good.
Yeah, there you go, man. What a nice surprise. I was not like...
Honestly, this is a nice surprise. Honestly, it's... The interface itself is so simple. So it's like... Doesn't really in your face with jam-packed with everything. I kind of like that part.
Looking forward...
Just like... even though Arknights is very, very simple. It's like... It's very easy to navigate around.
This game at all, like when I saw screenshots of it, I was like, meh, well, whatever, we'll see. Even though it was by YoStar, I wasn't really kind of feeling it. But the next thing I know, I'm playing with Dolphin Bay, right? Next thing I know, Dolphin Bay's here.
Should we even tell him about dolphins?
So there are three banners that are currently in the game: the Awakening banner, the
Girl is UR level. Wow, and this girl is also you.
And then the Soul Summon banner, right? So the difference between these: the Awakening banner is a raid up banner, but she's not exclusive. You can get her out of the general banner. You can get her out of the general pool. So, yeah.
For now. Remember, this is your star. Eventually, they will introduce characters like Nian. The Nian, remember? Nian banner, remember? A very limited exclusive will never be out. Certain characters like Vulcan and Indra that cannot be summoned from this normal banner. You have to use the recruitment stages. And also, I'm not going to be surprised in the future if that happens. A fun fact is a lowly, but she is a tank. A lowly tank. Here's the thing. Engage in impact. We got Sayu. A lowly... But I remember she's actually that old. She's a lowly... I think she's a lowly bar. But she's a lowly with a... With a claymore. How awesome is that? Free to play Arknights. 45% my operator is E2 already. And the rest is E1. Nice. Actually, I haven't upgraded a lot. I just focus on the operators that I like. I'm following in the normal banner. Okay.
The rate is higher in this banner, but you can get her on accident in this banner if you want to.
Okay, that girl is really... Is that her? Is that her, a fallen? Because she... That's a lowly and she's holding a pillow. Wow, I guess right. A fallen?
The exclusive summon, this character you can only get out of this banner, and she's not in the pool yet. I'm sure just like in all games, they'll be added to the pool eventually.
It's not all the pool yet, Nian.
Very, very nice, Queen of the Forest.
Oh, so there's not, you have no idea if it's like, sometimes like in Arknights, you know the zip bags really like to tease you? In Arknights, the light really like to tease you, so apparently there's no teasing over here.
I'll get some dupes here. When you get duplicates, you get this little currency here, which will allow you to buy things out of the shop as well. So very, very nice. Let's see what else. We'll just do this rapid fire. This video has gone on long enough. I got to get back to playing. I got stuff to do. I got to unlock guilds.
Okay. SR are the same colors. Golden light is an SSR.
I really want this archer chick. Archer assassin girl.
Oh, this guy's skipping. No wonder. There's no right. Tense moment. We're gonna have a tense moment during streaming, okay? Hilda's looks nice. Reminds me of Jean, but Geo Jean.
Duplicates. Ripper Rooney. But you know what? These are some really awesome characters. Not mad about that. As you guys can see, the pity is different on every single banner. So 80 pities here to get me a guaranteed Dolphin Bay, but I was lucky enough to get her already. 55 more, I'll get little Archer Bay here, and then 80 over here. So all of the pities are separate depending on the banner. But that will do it. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, a nice little look at Revived.
What the heck?
Which... highly recommend this one. Give it a try. It starts off a little slow. It definitely starts off a little slow. Like I said, I highly recommend throwing on your mini map if you're not really in a RPG explorey type of mood. It'll streamline the campaign a little bit, and then just sit back, enjoy the awesome pixels, the awesome, you know, fan service brought to you by
awesome fan service. This guy knows your style.
Yostar. Here is my little ID here if you want to add me as a friend. For whatever reason, this game is weird. You can only add people to your friends list if that person is online right now.
What? Hey, that is weird.
What are you doing? Why am I getting a thumbs down? Look at these cute emojis.
Wait, you can chat? You can chat with someone on your friends list? Where's the... Oh, frick. I accidentally pressed the other button in the game again. The YouTube again. Ouch. This one has no chat. Oh, shoot. Where was it?
I gotta get back to playing. I got stuff to do. I gotta unlock guilds. Rapid
bad
fire
PT.
All the way.
This
I really want this Archer
man,
chick.
FGO messed
Archer
me up.
Assassin girl.
How bad is FGO? Man, you guys are like, is that bad? The pity rate?
Feibe? All right.
Okay, summon.
And
oh, yeah, we were here.
All duplicates. Ripper Rooney. But you know what? These are some really awesome characters. Not mad
FGO
about that.
Doesn't have a pity. Not even like every four pulls guarantee 5-star and above. Once in a while. Because if doesn't have that, then... Ouch.
As you guys can see, the pity is different on every single banner. So 80 pities here to get me a guaranteed Dolphin Bay, but I was lucky enough to get her already. 55 more, I'll get little Archer Bay here. And
wait,
then...
what? 55 more? Wow, okay, that's a bit specific. That's good. Not idea, not... Oh, Carl said 300 pulls. Hi-ya.
Be over here. So all of the pities are separate depending on the banner. But that will do it. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, a nice little look at Revived Witch. Highly recommend this one.
So I assume this is a solo or solo campaign, because Even though you can chat with friends, I don't see like a co-op option.
Give it a try. It starts off a little slow. It definitely starts off a little slow. Like I said, I highly recommend throwing on your mini map if you're not really in a RPG explorey type of mood. It'll streamline the campaign a little bit, and then just sit back, enjoy the awesome pixels, the awesome, you know, fan service brought to you by YoStar. Here is my little ID here if you want to add me as a friend. For whatever reason, this game is weird. You can only add people to your friends list if that person is online right now.
Hey. I just saw what Zack Snyder actually did. Have the pities from other people pity on you. Man, I feel that. I remember when pulling for Hu Tao. I was so happy, yes. So pity Hu Tao 70 plus pool. Definitely Hu Tao coming out and ka-ching! Decided to show a lovely face to me. How nice.
Hey, what you doing? Why am I getting a thumbs down? Look at these cute emojis.
Why do I feel like a feeling of deja vu just now?
Yeah, you can only add friends if they're online at the moment. I have no idea why this, that's a thing. I have no clue. But look at this. You see my little thingy? Look at what? This. Normally, I don't use males as my my little picture. Okay. But it looks funny because he's super serious, but he's wearing bunny ears. I don't know. All right, guys, I am out. Thank you guys a ton for watching. Enjoy. I'll be back once I open up more gameplay modes. I know there's more. People in my Discord have already unlocked more things. And speaking of Discord, if you're crazy enough to make it this far into the video, I do have a fresh Discord link right at the top pinned comment of this video. 50 spots are available.
So, yep, that's it. That's the video so far. What the frick is that? Honestly, I have to thank Hellgate for this Wicked Witch. No, Revive Witch. Because watching the video about Nikado or something earlier really pulls my mojo down. It was like, when I look at him, it's like, this game really lifts me up. And we're talking about degenerating stuff, so really lifts me up. Just like how the bra managed to lift Utage up. Utage's assets. Right, we were supposed to watch Ember is a great support. I thought we already watched it, no? That one. The classifying Genshin players. Give me that one. The Ember is already done. Is the other one? Is the classifying Genshin players that we should be watching. Yeah, classifying. So definitely I'm a filthy casual. I'm that filthy. Okay, Utage is saying something. Is it gonna change? Oh yeah, for the first time we got ourselves a character that actually moves on screen, which is kind of cool. I really like this. I really love that. So I'm gonna move her down a bit to show off her monster. Hell yeah. Should I even farm more? Is it okay? You know, I'm gonna farm in the meantime, so I'm gonna just gonna farm for two again while we're doing some. Alright, so already watched the Ember, no worries. So let's see. What kind of Genshin Impact players are you guys? Are you filthy casual like me or not? Let's see.
Genshin Impact is a game that attracts many.
Okay, this is the one I'm talking about, Genshin Impact. Okay, I'm going to put 1.25. I don't care. That's a bit too slow for me. I'm going to go for 1.25.
People. They're starting casual. Off, we got the casual gamers. Missing a couple days of Genshin doesn't mean shit. You probably go to bed with cap resin, do a...
Only for the past few months, yes. But the first last year, I've been playing Genshin Impact. No, every day I will make sure I spend a lot of my resins. So only recently, quite a few months, ever since the pandemic started, in my country, then I started to slow down on that one.
Couple commissions here and there, whack a couple rocks, and log off.
I don't even bother trying to farm for the rocks. I just do the daily one.
You don't spend a lot of time playing because you might be busy playing other games. You got a job.
I remember that part.
Or maybe you're mentally stable.
Okay, my reason kept at most of the time. Yeah, I need to minimize the game. Okay.
Moving on, we got the regulars. You try your best to do all your dailies, weeklies, and occasionally some ores and artifacts.
Oh, that was me last year, definitely. That's me last year for nearly 1 year playing Genshin Impact. That's me.
Collecting. You consistently max your battle pass and your knowledge of the game.
Sorry, I don't use the battle pass. I just try to max the top one, not the one on the battle pass on the bottom itself.
Game is decent.
It is simply because I don't have any budget for that one.
But nothing too impressive. You know which character uses which artifact, but who cares? You don't have any good artifacts.
Wait, who cares? If you don't have any good artifact, I care. So I'm not a regular?
Last but not least, we got the hardcore gamer.
So I should get a laptop. Because if I got a laptop, my body will be buffed like that. I'm a filthy PC user. PC master race, and that guy is using a laptop. He's already buffed. Should I get a laptop then? Why do you spend Urgent Prime for sanity? Because I always use that. No worries. It's my strategy. For me, I want to upgrade my units. No worries. Yes, we don't have any good artifacts. That's what he says. So no wonder you said that painful, because you saw me using it for sanity. Here's the thing. I just used the original one just for the pull banners. I don't want to use it to pull banners. I know a lot of people use it for the banners itself. For me, I have a lot of units to upgrade. So I want to pull, I want to farm those artifacts. I'm going to upgrade all of them. No worries, I got like 100 plus units trying to pull extra. That's what I do. No worries about that, man.
These are not gamers, but workers who wake up every day to clock into work to farm fucking blue rocks. You spend hours every day grinding mobs, collecting materials, and farming artifacts. This is not a gacha game. This is an RPG to become the next anime protagonist. You want to become so powerful that you isekai the truck, not yourself.
What the F?
So far.
What the?
Anime protagonist, you want to become so powerful that you isekai the truck, not yourself. So.
Okay, that is painful. Okay, because I always read manga, but watching it in motion like that is painful. I cannot imagine a real life version adaptation of these animes, the isekai genres. Ouch. You isekai the truck. I use the Prime for skins. I never bought the skins. Not even once. Yep, not even once. I never bought it. But I just use the free ones. Yeah, efficiency over. Some people say, why did you buy the skins? I don't care. I just want to upgrade my units. That's it.
Far, we have the casual.
This is it. I am. That's why I consider myself as a filthy casual.
Well, the regular.
Heck, even to tower defense, this Genshin Arknights requires a lot of thinking during CC event. I try to brute force my way if possible.
Healers, the hardcore gamers, and the psychopaths. You need to farm everything. You need
the what?
To know everything. You need to do everything. You're basically in a loop of never being satisfied. When it comes to ores and crystals, you are the mining company. People.
Thank goodness I'm not a psychopath.
Will ask you for help about the game, and you don't know just the characters, but their whole ancestry as well. Whether it's
what?
Facts, mechanics, characters.
Enemy is called Zombie Land for a reason. Zombie Land. Okay, so I gotta remember that. Zombie Land Saga. Okay. Zombie Land Saga. We'll check that out later. Zombie Land Saga. Okay.
Just lore, or maybe taking a shower, the min max life chose you, and you'll fulfill it to the end. What keeps you going is doing 10 more damage than last week.
Wow, and we were debating here. We were discussing Hellgate regarding the weapon for Diluc. Rain Slasher was it? And you know what? As I said, I already set up Diluc for after a long time ago, so I'm too lazy to find new artifacts, trying to upgrade them. I'm too lazy to change. I'm so happy with the Arknight prototype of the fish for him, and that's it.
We then move on.
There is some that has worse vehicle crashes. Anime got good music. Yeah, I have to agree on that part.
On to the artifactors. You chase artifacts that don't fucking exist. If you don't roll five times in the crit, it's trash, and you love gambling. When looking at an artifact with one good subset, you think to yourself, maybe this is the one.
Lord have mercy, I'm about to bust.
Next, we have the Touch Starve. These guys have been edging their whole lives that anything remotely arousing would cause the next Yellowstone eruption in their pants.
Wait, what?
This lady needs our help.
Whether it's booba or caca, these people are everywhere, from armpit sniffers to whatever the fuck this is.
Oh, what? 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 What thing is armpit sniffers? What the fuck is that? What the fuck is this?
You guys need help.
The collector.
You swipe every banner to pull characters that you'll never use.
Can I consider myself, because you know, only recently I stopped doing that at Arknights because I want to save the region. But before this, I always swipe at every banner trying to get the guaranteed 5 star within the 10 pool. So I'm very happy if I can get in one pool, not so happy on the 10 pool. But I always do that in Arknights for the past 1 year plus. So am I considered a collector?
I'm new to the game and I pulled C10 Gundus. Is she any good? I also pulled some 5 stars using my last wish. Am I luck?
How? 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 How bloody lucky are you guys?
Key, I'm straight to say. Did I mention that? Do you guys know I'm straight to say?
Okay. That guy pisses me off. What happened to my dialogue? What the fuck happened to my dialogue? Who the heck is the MMD community? Oh, freaking the fuck. Poor dialogue. Oh, I'm just gonna move forward.
You're a GigaChat who spends time analyzing frame data of characters, and you know all the glossary terms used by your fellow five heads. You drink mineral water instead of normal water because there isn't enough nutrients in normal water to fill your big.
Nah, I'm just drinking it simply because I couldn't afford to buy cola every single day.
Gashead, why study for your exam next week when you can develop a PhD in elemental gauge theory? Level 10 trust rank, max vials, all realms unlocked, furnishing set on standby, and is full of companionships.
Oh, I'm definitely not an architect, I can tell you that. Heck, I'm quite surprised a lot of people want to speedrun the Serenity pod. I was like, what the F are you talking about? You guys want to speedrun that? Only recently I managed to get rank 10 in finally finished the last rank in Serenity Port. Recently! So you can already imagine. I'm too lazy to build things. MMD is weird. What the heck is an MMD? What happened to Dialogue? What did they do to my poor Dialogue? Oh god.
In-game companionships. You spend 10 hours rotating a tree for the best position, and you agree that the boar is the best pet. People.
I know it's haram, but I do have a pet pig in the Serenity pot.
Out here flexing damage, but maybe the real flex was how big was your stone call.
Wait, what? I kinda missed that part. Can you repeat that?
People out here flexing damage, but maybe the real flex was how big was your stone call.
Okay, what the heck is a cloud chaser?
Speaking of flexing, we got the cloud chasers. You chase the big numbers and dream of becoming the best DPS in the game. You might think DPS stands for damage per second, but it's actually damage per screenshot. Get your food buffs, Mona, Bennett, and a copious amount of luck because you all in crit damage and bang on.
Oh, what the fuck? Is that possible? Crit damage? But the. How is that even freaking possible? What the fuck are they? Wow! And yes, then I know that I'm trying to get as. I only obsess on Bailu and this and the others, I don't really care. Even I think you guys saw it. I only use the when against the what the latest boss, Wolf Floater, Wolf Loter, Wolf Shoulder. I don't remember the name of the wolf. Yeah, the most important thing is that flying Geo Wolf. And when I panic, I only use the food. But afterwards, I don't even use the food and just attack it as normal. Okay. I'm still level 5 in Serenity Pot. Yeah, I just reached level 10. Just take it easy, man. There's no need to speedrun like everyone. Speedrun the pot to be lazy for it later. Ja! Ah! Blue! Blue speedruns it! 3 crit rate is minimum. Ever opinion on speedrunning a game? Why does people always do that? It's for the challenge. For the game. It's for the fun itself. Try to YouTube. Speedrun Zelda BOTW. They managed, those crazy people managed to find a way to beat the endgame battle. Remember, Zelda is Genshin Impact copies like Zelda itself. And Zelda, they managed to endgame within 20 plus minutes. A content that's so huge. I've seen the map, it's huge, and they managed to do it in 20 freaking minutes. Wow! Why? Because they find it exciting. They love it. 20 minutes for me. Wow, so many. But the most important thing is fun. Why people do that? It's always for fun or money. Simple as that. Why Nico Avocado do that? It's for the views and for the money. Seriously. Who isn't jealous? He purchased a 2.4 million penthouse. This is one of the cheapest water on the market. And this is refilled again and again and again. I can't even understand that. Whose internet is mine? Dying. Oh, mine. Us Bruneian. Yeah, blue is correct. It's nearly 7 o'clock. Blue understands. It's nearly 7 o'clock. Whenever 7 o'clock approaches in this country, the internet decided to go full or drunk. So I'm not going to be surprised. So let's try to first check this one before the 1% it really crit dies rate. Out.
The sky's not the limit for you. It's the fucking moon. You could be dying from a B12 deficiency, but that's not going to stop you from refreshing the page for new leaks to eat. You consume the latest information on Genshin, always preparing for the next patch when you haven't even played the current patch.
Thank goodness that's not me. Seriously. When you ask me what's the latest... I ask you guys what's the latest. I always ask Seed, what's the latest news? I don't even bother watching the stream. The Genshin Impact stream.
They don't exist.
So true. I tried to make a senior main, but Dinook is far superior. I think because of the E itself, yeah.
Hey, what can I say? You like getting shafted every day. Waking up to get abused from all directions is normal. And you can be seen in dark alleyways sniffing the area for leftover Primo Gems and Mora. You're a free to play with a whale mentality. And the longer you play, the more you think, hey, maybe I really am a masochist.
Damn it. Okay. I'm not pure free to play. I actually spent a bit in the beginning. Then I stop.
Genshin is your first gacha game. You don't know what's worse, gacha games or actually liking it. You find joy in summoning and being blissfully ignorant of the gacha aspects during your honeymoon phase. Being fairly new to the genre, you go into every banner expecting...
Yeah, I still remember the break. I can't remember the recent game, but the first gacha, I can't remember the first gacha game I played, but I remember Bravely Default. It was like trying to get an SSR unit. It was like, whoa, finally. And then I posted on Facebook for everyone to say, everyone, yeah, congrats nowadays.
To actually get the banner character, you've been fucked in the ass by monetization from so many other gacha games that Genshin is just another game to fuel your gacha addiction. You pull to numb the pain that is being at the mercy of RNGesus, and you start scheduling more months of cup ramen. A tear runs down your cheek as you whisper sweet words into your ear in Jesus, and you start scheduling more months of cup ramen.
Let me do this one. How come it's a bit slow? So it means that every time I use this to purchase sanity, someone who's watching my stream outside feels they will be in pain because it's why am I not spending on gacha or skins? Because I can. it's been fine for the past. Yeah, it's already Hellgate, and don't be surprised. As I said, whenever it starts 6 p.m. onwards, the internet is getting bad and bad here in my country. We have no idea why. It's supposed to be upgraded, but here's the thing: during the day it was fine, but at night, what the frick happened?
Self. Maybe this is the one.
Wait, what?
Game. You might think DPS. The more you think, hey, maybe I really am a Matsuki. Genshin is your first gacha game. You don't know what's worse, gacha games or actually liking it. You find joy in summoning and being blissfully ignorant of the gacha aspects during your honeymoon phase. Being fairly new to the genre, you go into every banner expecting to actually get the banner character. You've been fucked in the ass by monetization from so many other gacha games that Genshin is just another game to fuel your gacha addiction.
Oh god, and so close to joy revive, wait! So close!
You pull to numb the pain that is being at the mercy of RNGesus and you start scheduling more months of cup ramen. A tear runs down your cheek as you whisper sweet words into your ear that eating is optional.
Eating is optional? No!
You can't run the fucking game. Not to be confused with min-maxers, you collect for the sake of collecting. Not to be confused with min-maxers.
That's a I only have 100 plus. Whoa, that's a lot, man. What the heck is happening?
You collect for the sake of collecting. The more shit you have in your inventory, the bigger your magnum dong gets. You spend hours exploring mountains, gliding through rivers, and setting up a photo booth wherever you go. The camera is your best friend, and you have a collection of the same 100 photos, but the angle is 1 degree different every time.
What?
If you have given as much fucks as you did reading Genshin theories and being emotionally invested about the story into your own real-life lore, you could have been the main protagonist by now.
Wow, okay, thank goodness I didn't really follow the lore itself. I just rely on the subreddit to give a summary of it, even Arknights itself. I don't even bother reading every single one, freaking one of those, so yeah. Wow. How's the internet so far, guys? For me, it's okay. It seems okay for now. But as I said, it's nearly approaching the server reset. I'm not going to be surprised if my internet was suddenly kaput by this time. Wow. Man, this guy. Okay, but he's going to upvote on that one. Did I give a like on the other one? Okay, don't need that. No. Okay, is it the one just now? What's your favorite Genshin Impact character says about it? I think we watched it before? I can't remember. Let me double check. Okay.
Look.
I did watch
you
it.
You like before. Being abused. Yes, please whale me.
Wait, what? I like being a what?
Kiaya. You're a gold digger. Lisa. Rock climbing is your hobby. Binti yours.
So I do like Lisa.
You're into femboys.
Thank goodness I'm not.
Razor. You're okay. A furry.
Wait, what?
Omae no nioi. Ii nioi. Issho ni kari o shiyou.
Itaku mo kayuku mo nai kougeki deshita ne.
You smell nice. Let's hunt.
Ha 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 Okay.
Clay.
But yeah, I actually don't use anymore Razor itself simply because I don't know. I got a good team already. Maybe I'll try to rebuild him in the future. I don't know. Oh, is it? I think the idea of not changing characters, what that stopped me changing, because whenever I burst him, it's like you need to maximize his hitting with this wolf spirit guardian or whatever to maximize damage. So that's kind of put me off a bit.
Bennett.
Okay.
Annoying MF.
Out.
Benny, 冒険団, 出発!
Amber. You're actually really sweet, but don't do shit for group projects. Sucrose.
Okay.
You get off to Neko Para.
What the heck is a Neko Para?
Checking.
I don't want to Google that. I really, really don't want. Fun fact, did you know that my wallpaper is a smiling Xinyan? Nope. Yes, you may have a problem. Let's see, Xinyan. Ka-ching!
You are slightly into your sister.
Whoa! Ouch!
Official.
Ah, official's good.
You want an emo goth GF.
Okay. Don't Google it on stream. Thank you for the advice. I will not Google it on stream. What the heck is a Neko Para? I'm gonna show whatever this.
You're pretty chill, but question yourself a lot.
Also, another character I hardly use.
Zhong Li.
Hell yeah.
You have daddy issues.
Oh fuck!
You like 30 boys that are way out of your league and call you fat.
What the fuck is that? Yeah, this is a cool English intro. Oh. The fuck, girl? Are you okay?
Ningwen.
Oh, okay. It's a R18 game. Oh, so it's a game that I'm not supposed to stream also then. Okay. Ningguang.
You have mommy issues. Jean will be down.
Okay, I love you.
You want the tough on SN to step on you.
What? No.
Payman. Bro. Zhao.
Okay.
You're MF sexy and you smell good.
What the fuck?
Zhang.
So whoever got Zhao, or who likes Zhao, they're... They got a positive one of all.
You eat too much. Bubble.
That's been because Avocado will definitely love Xiang Ling.
Sacrilegious.
Is it because they're friends to her voice change? Wait. Oh, yes. The senior is already done. Alright. No, well, here's the thing. Hellgate already warned me. I'm not going to be tricked by you, Mr. Blue. Neko Para anime is awesome, though. I am not going to Google that. I have to be very, very careful. Okay. So, here's the thing. It's nearly 7 o'clock. I suspect Nintendo will go coo after this. So, better I stop now. Anime is awesome. You guys are trying to convince me an R18 game got a wholesome anime? It's like a doujinshi master making a decent famous manga for everyone to read. Oh wait, there is one. I can't remember which author. He started off as a hentai artist and he got a famous manga. Oh wow, I forgot the name of the... I can't remember which series is that. There is one series. He's famous for hentai, then he moved to manga. And that manga is famous. I can't remember the name of the manga itself. Wow. Wow, okay. I actually had to... Anyway, so I'm going to stop the stream now. Nagatori, is it? I can't remember. Oh, wait! Yes! Nagatoro, the bully girl, yeah, I think he's the one, right? Yeah, he's famous for the community. They don't ask how I know. Okay, so, I'm gonna stop the stream now because, oh shoot, my OBS is screaming now. Nagatoro is, yeah, awesome. Okay, you guys prove me, I will check Nakapara after this, after the stream. Anyways, OBS is screaming right now. So I have to, that means it's time for me to quit streaming and I'm gonna see you guys tomorrow, okay? I will decide if I'm going to play Revive Witch or not. If I play Revive Witch, expect me to fudge it up in the beginning. Alright, Senpai, show me. Because last time I started a YoStar game 1 month late, suddenly I got stuck with it until now. So hope you enjoyed the stream. I'm sorry, apologies for being derailed a lot and talking about Nico Avogadro a lot and talking and being degenerative a lot. But yeah, sorry about that. It's just that it's fun when we discuss this a lot of stuff without any reservation and such. I know I can be proven wrong. No worries, prove me wrong and I will correct myself. All right. Anyways, hope you enjoyed the stream. And I'll see you next time. Yesterday I decided to have an off day because I've been streaming a lot. So having an off day once in a while really, really cleansed the soul. So I hope you enjoy the stream and I'll see you next time. Enjoy life. Enjoy your day. And Blue, good luck with the internet tonight. You know what I'm talking about, right? This is UNN. Hey, ciao, TTFN!